Well, tomorrow is a big day in politics. It's primary day in 12 different states across the country. There are a lot of key races to watch, including one in Nevada, where the winner of the Republican primary will challenge the Senate Majority Leader, Harry Reid. Reid is considered vulnerable, because of the anti-incumbent climate across the country. But a lot depends on which candidate wins the Republican primary. Texas Senator John Cornyn is chairman of the National Republican Senatorial Committee, and we also invited, we should say, Senator Robert Menendez to join us. He's the chairman of the Democratic Senatorial Campaign Committee. He was not available. Senator Cornyn, we're glad that you were. Thanks for being here, sir. And let's talk about the California primary first, because we're looking at a former Hewlett-Packard CEO, a very accomplished businesswoman in Carly Fiorina, who's up against Chuck DeVore here. Polls show that Fiorina is going to pull this out, right?
That's what it looks like. This has been a hard-fought primary out in a very big, expensive state to run in. And so far, the polling looks like Carly Fiorina will be the Republican nominee. That will be decided by California primary voters tomorrow, as you point out.
As we take a look at Chuck DeVore, he is the candidate that has gotten a lot of support from the Tea Party movement, right?
Well, Sarah Palin endorsed Carly Fiorina. Carly Fiorina is a very conservative candidate, one who, frankly, I think would appeal to a broad spectrum of Republican primary voters, including Tea Party participants. So I think the numbers speak for themselves. Her surge, really, here late against Tom Campbell to become the nominee, likely nominee, I think is a credit to her campaign, her message, and I think she'll be the strongest candidate we have against against Barbara Boxer in November.
I mentioned the race in Nevada in the introduction here. This is for the right to challenge the Senate Majority Leader, Senator Reid. In that state, it seems as though a candidate named Sharon Angle is surging, speaking of surge. What are you hearing?
Well, we're hearing the same, but you know, this is important to remember in Nevada, is that Harry Reid's numbers are really very bad for an incumbent. He's, of course, had to carry water for the president's agenda here in Congress, and that means the failed stimulus, this monstrosity of a health care bill that most people in Nevada would like to see repealed and replaced with something else that made sense, and just the endless spending and debt. So this will be a referendum really on Senator Reid, and I believe that all of the Republican candidates who could win tomorrow, all of them are leading him now, but if Sharon Angle is the nominee, I'm confident she can beat Harry Reid in November.
And Sharon Angle, in this case, is the candidate in this particular primary who's gotten a lot of support from the Tea Party movement. But speaking of that head-to-head matchup in the general election, an article in the Las Vegas Journal Review, Senator, said that Angle would have a much tougher time beating Senator Reid than would one of her opponents, businessman Danny Tarkanian, in Nevada. The matchup is 44-41% if she takes the nomination. Meanwhile, he would beat Harry Reid 46-39%, and yet he's not ahead in this race.
Yeah, well, that's what primaries are all about, where Republican primary voters can sort this out. We certainly respect their choice, and we will come together, I believe, as a party to support that nominee. Really, I think Senator Reid has to be one of the most endangered incumbents in Washington these days, again, because he's been carrying a very unpopular agenda of the President of the United States, and one that the people of Nevada simply don't agree with. So I think no matter who our nominee is, I think we stand a very good chance to win that race, but we will come together behind whoever that is after the polls close on Tuesday, and I'm confident we'll pick up that seat in November.
Final question, Senator Cornyn. I'm just wondering, when we talk about the Tea Party movement, and I'm wondering your take on the effect that the movement has had on these primaries coming up and also on the Republican Party as a whole. Has it been a good thing overall?
I think the Tea Party has been a very important grassroots movement all across the country. We see a lot of people who haven't been involved necessarily in political races in the past who've gotten very energized because they've been scared about the direction our country's going into. So I think it's been a very positive thing. A recent New York Times poll said 57% of independents sympathize with the Tea Party movement. These are patriotic Americans who are concerned about the direction our country is headed and want to make sure that we turn this around. And with their help, we will in November.
Senator John Cornyn of Texas, thanks so much for your time today, sir. We appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
And for the best